Hi guys, thank you so much for joining me and welcome to my channel. For those of you who don't know, my name is Brittany, and today we're going to be taking a inside look into my pantry and fridge. I just love to organize, and this is a space that certainly could use functionalization and organization in any house. So I picked up a few items that I'm going to be using, and there are still a few things that I think will be beneficial in the future that I'll be adding as well. So stay tuned for future videos regarding this space. But I hope this is helpful for you. I hope it inspires you to make over your pantry and fridge as well. And please subscribe, and I hope you enjoy it.
So a few days ago, I picked up these storage bins. They were purchased at Ocean State Job Lot and were so affordable. They were less than $2 a piece on average. And I did pick up a mixture of the plastic gray ones, as you can see, and the hard acrylic clear ones that I'm going to be using for different purposes. So stay with me and let's get started. For sake of time, I already migrated all of my items into the new bins, and I'll now go through the pantry and fridge separately to show you what I've done. Starting at the bottom of this pantry, I used the floor space for Gavin's formula and leftover items that did not fit into the bins within the pantry and or fridge. In the near future here, I would love to get many of these floor items off the ground. I have seen things that latch onto the wire rack under here that provide additional storage, and that would be great for some of the bottled drinks or even my shopping bags and coolers. After filming, I went online and found these great containers that might absolutely work. So stay tuned for a future video if I decide to buy this. Moving on to where we used the new storage bins, these are three bins here that I decided to use as color-coordinated bins for Gavin's allergy-friendly food. So in here, he'll have his gluten-free granola bars, his fruit pouches, his specialty cookies, and things like that. Anything with a gray bin, Gavin can help himself too. Moving here, we have Mason's snack bins. They are in different colors so that Mason knows he can help himself to those and we don't have to worry about cross-contamination. And the reason that I selected these particular bins as opposed to something that might match my style a little better, such as a wicker basket or something, is that these just slide so easily on the wire shelving. Moving on to the second shelf, where we decided to place the acrylic organizers for canned goods and other single serve items, such as these Easy Mac mac and cheese cups for Mason. He absolutely loves these for lunch or an easy dinner, and also single serve applesauce and olives. Over here, we just have a few more bins and baskets. Some of these I already previously had in the pantry. These store our extra condiments and cooking supplies, such as our sauces, oils, salts, and even some nut butters. Things that I do not want the kids to have access to because they might be in a glass jar, as well as our peanut butters and maple syrup. Although these bins are quite a bit heavier than the ones below, they still slide very easily on this wire racking and are very convenient for accessing items that might be in the back. As you can tell though, the acrylic ones do not seem to slide as easily, but they are still very convenient for grabbing. Moving on up, you will find our starches and other side dishes such as pastas and sauces, both gluten-free and traditional, as well as our rice products, our quinoa, couscous, and potatoes. These bakeable baked potatoes are a family favorite. These ones are sweet potato, but they're so convenient in that they are pre-washed and only need to be microwaved for 8 minutes, and then they're all done. And over here, we just have our individual oatmeal packets and crackers, as well as our cereal. These are all in Tupperware containers, which I prefer over many other brands. Moving on up, we reserve the top space for additional storage and items that we do not use as frequently, such as our baking products and cookbooks. While I love to bake, I just don't have much time to these days with the two boys. But that is it for the pantry. I hope some of these tricks were helpful for you, and let me know if you have any questions. Okay, moving on to our refrigerator. These doors and the freezer drawer is currently locked by the Munchkin latch system. Gavin and Mason love to pull out the doors and leave it open, and this just prevents them from taking out items without me knowing and it going bad. I did just go to the grocery store, so we are very fully stocked. Our fridge comes with a neat door-in-door feature, so we're able to store waters and juice and milk in a convenient and easy-to-access door that keeps the rest of the refrigerator closed and cool. Opening it up here, you'll see that there is a cute peekaboo window, which also gives you access from this side as well. It not only looks cool, but it's also very functional. Next, I'm going to show you just some of the new organizers that I purchased, such as this pull-out one here that we are using for our fruit cups, and one up top here that we are using for Mason's yogurt pouches, and one for our canned drinks. Okay, and now just to get into some of the drawers, this one here always contains all of our vegetables. We love vegetables and always keep this space very stocked with green beans and mixed veggies, salad mixes, things like that. And in this drawer here, we always store our bread products. We have plenty of gluten-free options as well as traditional products and bagels. We definitely love carbs in this house, so this drawer is always very well stocked. And since my in-laws were in town this weekend, we now have plenty of leftovers to last us the rest of the week, which is always a good thing. And in this drawer here, we have miscellaneous items such as our deli meat and cheese products, and also these chicken nuggets for Mason. He loves these and we always keep them on hand. And also products like chicken sausage here, which is a favorite amongst the kids. We also just keep some miscellaneous side dishes such as glazed apples or sometimes pre-made mashed potatoes. And also use this space for our fruits, such as grapes and strawberries, and also our eggs. So that is it for the refrigerator. As you can see, we're very well stocked with both new groceries and leftovers, as well as meals for the week. But these new storage solutions, I think, were very useful in providing just a little bit of organization. Heading on into our freezer now, most of these products I did already go over in my allergy-friendly meals, so I will do this quickly, such as these Simply Smart chicken tenders for Gavin that are gluten-free, and also our meat products such as our chicken breasts and steak. And in here we also just store our breakfast options for the kids, such as these waffles, and some lunch options including these Uncrustable sandwiches, which Mason absolutely loves. There's not too much in terms of organization just because everything comes in an awkward carton or cardboard box. So that's going to do it for today's video. I hope this was interesting for you all and helpful in providing you with some storage ideas for your home as well. If you haven't already, please hit subscribe and comment below, and I will see you all in my next video.